All right, I am here in the, what is this room called?
The Commercial Appeal News Library.
The Commercial Appeal News Library. I'm with Rosemary and Jan. Mm-hmm. And they are the Commercial Appeal sleuths of sorts. What is it exactly that you guys do?
Well, we do a lot of different things. The most enjoyable thing, and probably the most important, is doing research for reporters and editors in the newsroom. Jan just got a question phoned in. What was your question, Jan? It sounded like one I'm going to run away from.
Well, this goes back a little ways. I got a question from a reporter who wants to know what the voter turnout was, both percentage-wise and number-wise, of the special election back in 1982. When Dick Hackett, who used to be the mayor of Memphis, beat out Otis Higgs and some other folks. And the only way we can really find that is to go back to the old clips. Because unfortunately our archive only goes back to about 1990, where we can get full text of all the stories. But to get things prior to that, like in 1982, we're going to have to rely on the old clips.
So you basically have to rummage through all the old information to find whatever it is that somebody is looking for.
Right. Of course, it's all organized, hopefully. We will have folders, clip files over here.
Yeah, if you want to pan over, okay. We can show you one of our fun machines. This is the Lectriever, and it was installed, I guess, 20 years ago to contain the clips that were kept in the old morgue. That's what this used to be called, the morgue.
Wait, this is a machine? This is not just shelves?
This is a machine. You can get to what you need. Let's go to elections. That would be on row 11. And there we go.
That is so cool.
When we have school kids come through, they enjoy this part.
I need one of these in my house.
That would be good.
Yeah, closets there or shelves, you know.
That would be convenient. I wouldn't have to worry about bookshelf space ever again.
And we have it organized by elections and the year. Elections Tennessee, elections Memphis, elections mayoral. What year?
1982.
I'm seeing a lot of 80. Okay. Here's 82. And back in the olden days, people would sit here and clip the paper, cut it up, and then pick a keyword to file it under. It's usually a name, but it could be a subject. And if there were several names in the article, they would have to make copies and make clips for each of the names. And then they would put the date on it, and they would eventually be filed in a file like this.
So,
and believe it or not, these are still used quite frequently by reporters and by us to find information.
That is really cool. So I understand not all of your questions are that sane or normal. What are some of the weirder questions you've gotten?
I think our favorite one of all time was, how much would Elvis weigh on the moon? And I don't even remember why that question came up.
Yeah, I don't.
But I think we did finally come up with an answer. Maybe we talked to an expert physicist or something, I don't know, but found it in a resource.
We did, I remember one question that we had was about the FedEx Forum, and they were trying to figure out, trying to make it explainable to people so they could understand how large it actually was. Mm-hmm. And so we found out that, I can't remember what the exact number was, but we could say like 20 tennis courts could fit inside the FedEx Forum, so that people would kind of get an idea. You know how big a tennis court is, and so if you see 20 of them, that's how big the FedEx Forum would be. So we get questions like that sometimes.
That's really cool. So do you remember how much Elvis weighs on the moon? No?
We can look it up again if you're interested.
That's all right. I was just curious. I was going to know so I could...
So often... We'll do work on a question in the next week. It's sort of out of your memory.
But we do have a huge Elvis collection to draw upon.
Nice.
I mean, we have, we still use books, actually. Not everything is online yet. But so
and
we still have like Elvis A to Z, and we have a bunch of Elvis books back there in case we have to.
We have the secret Elvis files, but we cannot show you those.
The secret Elvis files?
We do have secret Elvis files.
Wow.
In a secret location.
That is nigh on impressive.
Because
I didn't know there were secret Elvis files.
Our clips, sad to say, sometimes end up in reporters' back seats. So we have the Elvis.
So that's why
they're
secret Elvis files.
Yeah, protected pretty much.
I mean, we cannot be here 24/7, but the library is open pretty much 24/7 because there are reporters here all the time. So they're in and out, and things go in and out. And
I heard a rumor, actually, I think from you guys, that you have encyclopedic knowledge about one of Memphis's icons. Can you tell me a little bit about that?
It must be Justin.
That was the one. How do you come by encyclopedic knowledge of Justin Timberlake?
Well, this is something a bit new for us. In the past couple of years, we have started a kind of news alert service for the newsroom. We come in every morning about this time and do searches in various databases that we subscribe to find information on anything dealing with Memphis and other publications. And of course, Justin turns up a lot. He's one of the ones that turns up every day, as a matter of fact. And so Jan and I sort of put all the sports interesting things together, all the business things together, all the political things together, and ship them off to the beat reporters and the editors that need those things. And then we also put the best ones on our Twitter feed. So we now have 55 followers on Twitter.
Nice.
Yeah. It's getting up there. We just started that. So we're hoping to increase that as time goes on.
So do you think there's going to be secret Justin files someday?
Probably.
I don't know.
I don't know, but we hope to get our hands on them so we can collect all that kind of information, and we will be the people to come to down the road when people want secret Justin stuff.
There you go. Now you know.
For posterity.
Your future source of all secret Justin information. Now you know who to talk to.
Moving.
Here you go. Your biggest Justin Timberlake fans in the CA.
Here we are.